Lesson 15, using basketball to score in life. If you take yourself too seriously, you'll miss out on some lessons to be learned from playing a game of basketball. Basketball is similar to life in that it changes and evolves at each level. As a coach, there's no greater joy for me to witness a player become a man through the game of basketball. The lessons that you will learn in basketball will take you way beyond the basketball court. Discipline. I'm sure that everyone knows at least one person who has problems following through with the goals he or she has set for themselves. The root of the problem usually is a lack of discipline. I remember being a freshman at the University of Buffalo and saying to myself, why do we have to wake up at 5 o'clock every morning to do conditioning? Why not wait at least until the sun comes up? Well, the answer is that basketball was teaching me discipline. In life, you're going to come across obstacles and temptations. This is when discipline comes into play. Sometimes you have to be able to man up and do things you really don't want to do. Communication. During the course of playing basketball, you're going to have to talk to your teammates. It is valuable because in school, the majority of your classes require you to be quiet and do your own work. The real world is the exact opposite. It's why didn't you tell me that earlier? Or Larry is sick, so you have to finish his work. So make sure you're communicating. Another great thing about basketball is that it teaches you to communicate with people of different backgrounds. Every one of your teammates is different, and you can't use a one-size-fits-all strategy. You find that you have to talk softly to some people and more bluntly to others. Communication on the court requires that you use body language and keywords to get your message across. One of the most important skills of communication is conflict resolution. If you play long enough, you're going to disagree with your teammates. In fact, it happens on a daily basis. Most problems on the basketball court result from a lack of communication, whether that be a missed help side rotation or you're just not paying attention and you have a foot on the sideline for a turnover because you're out of bounds. You think that your teammate's going one way and then he does something else. The ball's stolen. Your center's out of position. Someone gets an easy bucket. When you're working as a team, you all have to be on the same page, and this is all through communication. This is why I love watching Duke play. Coach K teaches his team to communicate and make adjustments. That's why no matter what roster he puts on the basketball court, you can rest assured they'll be hard to beat and they'll be a great defensive team. After every foul, you'll see them immediately huddle up and communicate as a unit. They are a perennial powerhouse that's built on communication and trust. Responsibility. One for all and all for one. This is the first thing I teach to my kids when they come to play for me. If one guy is late, we all run. If one guy decides to mess around in school, we all run some more. What I'm teaching my players is they have the responsibility beyond themselves. Every one of my players knows that everything they do affects the team. Every player, no matter playing time, understands that they all are accountable to the team. The great thing about basketball is you get to refine your ability to work as a team every day. Whether you win or lose, every game is an opportunity to get better. I love watching basketball from November to March because each team matures its own way. It's because the game of basketball forces you to work as a team. Hard work and work until. Your work ethic is the one thing you control in a game of basketball. As a coach, I designed my practice to show me right away the players who are ready to go the extra mile. I challenge them mentally with different tasks and goals. If they complete their goal, we move on to the next drill. If they miss their goal, then it's time to run wind sprints and start all over. Even as a skills trainer, my job is to make sure I challenge each player with different and new drills each workout. Hard work is more than just running up and down the court. It's putting the extra effort when you're tired and the odds are stacked against you. You learn a lot about yourself when things are not going your way. It's easy to work hard when you're up 20, but what happens when you're down 30 and fatigued? This is when you find out if you're really a hard worker. Will to succeed. This is a lesson that every basketball player will have the opportunity to learn. Once you embrace the will to succeed, your life will never be the same. I call it the number one attitude. I remember talking to a golfer in my high school who was the number two golfer on the team. As a freshman, this was a lofty feat, but I told him it was not enough to settle for second. Every day I saw him, I teased him about being number two. It would be 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and I would ask him what time it was. I knew that he had two sisters, so I asked him how many sisters he had. Anything to do with the number two, I teased him on it. I didn't know it at the time, but I was stirring up the will to succeed inside of him. His junior year, he ended up being the number one golfer on the best golf team in the history of the state. Now he comes back and teases me this time, and every answer ends up being number one. Strategy. Basketball is a very strategic game because the variables always change. Before the game, you have to prepare as an individual and a team. You have to look at the other team you're playing against and strategize according to their strengths and weaknesses. This lesson will help you in life because you will naturally prepare for the questions, where do I fit in and how do I succeed? During the game, you'll find that you have to make decisions on the flow of the game. Time, score, and possession dictate your next move and what you should do going forward. Life is the same. To be successful, you have to be able to adjust on the fly. Just like when you miss a shot, you can't dwell on your misfortune. You have to concentrate on making the next one. After the game, your strategy changes as you reflect on your team and personal performance. Each team and player makes mistakes during the course of a game. In life, they say that those who don't learn from the past are destined to repeat it. You learn this lesson firsthand in the game of basketball. Dealing with adversity. During the course of your career, you're going to run into plenty of obstacles. Since basketball is a team sport, you're focused to deal with issues that affect the team, whether it's fighting back from a 20-point deficit or dealing with losing your best teammate to an injury. You have to learn to take life as it comes. The thing about basketball is you never know what's going to happen next. You can have the best team in the league, but if your team doesn't learn how to deal with adversity, you are one problem away from disaster. You learn how to turn negatives into positives. Whenever there's an issue with the framework of a team, someone has to step up. Every year, players are lost to graduation, injuries, and suspensions. In each of these situations, a team has to adjust and fill the void. Pick up any preseason basketball publication, and it's going to talk about which each team is losing and which each team is gaining. It's up to that team to find its own identity. The best teams use any form of adversity to become stronger as a unit. Teams that embrace adversity and use it as a stepping stone usually achieve great things. One of the things I like to do as a coach is put my players in situations that are not fair and just. Sometimes it's not calling a foul. Other times it's making them play 7-on-5. I let them know that everything isn't always going to work in their favor. If they can get through adversity in basketball, then life will become much easier for them. Friendship. There's something to say about going through tough times with teammates. You will find that a lot of people you compete with will become lifelong friends. When you're on a team, you form a special bond with your teammates. In pursuit of similar goals, you are forced to help each other out and look out for each other's best interests. This is where trust comes into play. College, as the captain of the team, I had the pleasure of welcoming the new guys to our family. Since I knew very little about these new guys, I figured the best way to find out was to play pickup. With pickup basketball, there's no coach or referee to control how things are done. It was only the rules I set forth and expected everyone to follow. One of my unwritten rules was to rarely call foul. Growing up in Jersey, you had to be tough. And we played a game called rough that is similar to what you would call 21 around the country. This game prepared players to become more physical, and this came in handy. During preseason pickup games, if I fouled you, I would continue playing to see your reaction. Of course, this told me right away the kind of guy you were. If you complained and let it affect your game, then I saw that as a weakness that we had to work on. On the other hand, if you kept playing and didn't let me get into your head, then I knew that you were going to help us win. It was these type of teammates that I became close with off the floor, and to this day, we have a lifelong bond.